Welcome to worship. It is good for us to be gathered together. Welcome to Our Savior's Lutheran Church. I'm Rob James, blessed to be one of your pastors. You know what I'm talking about, right? If I say exhausted joy, have you ever been like filled with joy and yet exhausted at the same time, right? It's a good exhaustion. That's where I'm at today. We had a fabulous time this weekend. We had 21 adults go on our first adult retreat to Lutherdale, one of our Bible camps over in Elkhorn, Wisconsin, and had a great time. So you'll be hearing more about that. We've got another one on the calendar already for November. So would love for you to join us at that. Our Savior's has a rich history with Lutherdale, and exciting for us to be able to connect there again and get away. It's amazing how putting your phone down for a mere 24 hours can just help you reset as you spend time with God and with others. So glad that Pastor Scott Stolberg is preaching today, and I didn't have to write a sermon, so that's even better. But we just want to say we're glad you're here. We're glad you're in worship today. There's something we do at the beginning of service. It's that where I tell you to reach out in front of you and grab an attendance card. We ask every household to fill one of those out, and we just drop those. And if you have offering to give, all those just go in the basket on our way out of worship. If you're a member, just filling out your name, checking the box, that's great. If this is your first time here or it's been a while, that's a great way to just give us your basic communication information. We just want to be in relationship, and that means we got to know how to get a hold of each other. And so any info that you share just allows us to be in conversation, let you know what's going on here at Our Savior's. You do have a bulletin and order of service so that you know what's coming when. But between myself, Pastor Scott, and Paula Mowbray, our director of worship music, we're going to tell you when to stand, sit, sing, pray, all that stuff that we do in worship. And I know that some of us today come with certainly a joy. We come ready to praise God and celebrate all that is good. And some of us find ourselves in worship because we drug ourselves here because we know we need something right now. And the beautiful thing is that we bring our full selves to worship. We bring all that we are to worship our good God. So I invite you to actually open your hands and lay them on your lap. This is a Lutheran church. Don't raise them too high, Jim. You'll freak people out. That was a joke, in case you didn't know. But I invite you to open your hands, lay them on your lap, take a deep breath. This is that reminder that we come in worship. We come to bring our prayers before God and community, but we also open ourselves up as the Holy Spirit dwells among us and as we are moved by the Spirit to be a part of answering not just these prayers, but the prayers of others around this world. And so again, just sit comfy there for a moment. Take a deep breath. Good and gracious God, we give thanks that we can gather to worship you as community, that we can come from different places with different stories, from different backgrounds, and yet you call us together to be side by side, to join together in proclaiming your word and lifting up our prayers and singing out our songs of praise. As we come to hear your word, to be transformed by your word, to be reminded that this living word, by the presence of your Holy Spirit, will speak to us and will move us. God, we bring our full selves, our joys, our struggles, our challenges, all that we are, we bring into this worship together. We give thanks, God, that you are the divine creator, that you've created all that is good. We give thanks that in Jesus Christ we know grace and love and mercy. We give thanks that the Holy Spirit is with us in this place and in all places where we go. As we worship you, we worship in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are able as we turn to our call to worship. God welcomes us in love, and we welcome as God welcomes. When we welcome others, we welcome Jesus. When we welcome Jesus, we welcome God, Mother, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We sing together.
Time to
We pray together. Gracious God, you set aside Paul and Barnabas for the work of sharing the good news. In the same way, call us into service to you and our neighbors near and far. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.
Our reading today is from Acts, the 13th and 14th chapter. Now in the church at Antioch, there were prophets and teachers, Barnabas, Simeon, who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manian, a member of the court of Herod and the ruler, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them." Then after fasting and praying, they laid their hands on them and set them off. In Lystra, there was a man sitting who could not use his feet and had never walked, for he had been crippled from birth. He listened to Paul as he was speaking, and Paul, looking at him intently and seeing that he had faith to be healed, said in a loud voice, "Stand up, right on your feet." And the man sprang up and began to walk. When the crowd saw what Paul had done, they shouted in the Lysonian language, "The gods have come down to us in human form." Barnabas they called Zeus, and Paul they called Hermes, because he was the chief speaker. The priest of Zeus, whose temple was just outside the city, brought oxen and garlands to the gates. He and the crowds wanted to offer sacrifice. When the apostles, Barnabas and Paul, heard of it, they tore their clothes and rushed out into the crowd, shouting, "Friends, why are you doing this? We are mortals just like you, and we bring you good news, that you should turn from these worthless things to the living God, who made the heaven and earth and the sea and all that is in them. In past generations, he allowed all nations to follow their own ways, yet he has not left himself without a witness in doing good, giving you rains from heaven and fruitful seasons, and filling you with food and your hearts with joy." Even these words, they scarcely restrained the crowds from offering sacrifice to them. It says the gospel of the Lord, but this is our reading for today. Praise to you all.
Any kids, come on up. I want to introduce you to a friend of mine.
Hi. You want to sit here? Can you see? Can you see there? Good. How's it going?
Good. Good. I'm going to introduce you to a friend of mine. Hello! This is Charlie. Charlie loves to say hello really loud. Hello!
What do you like to do?
Play with my neighbor Noah.
Play with neighbor Noah? What else? Who else? What do you like to do? You like to give high fives? I like high fives. High five? No. Do you like to play with dolls? Yeah. Me too. What else?
I don't know why they're not saying anything.
What do you like to do? Yes? Play practice. I like plays. I like where people say silly things. What else? You're scared of puppets, aren't you?
Charlie likes to share joy. Do you think it's fun to share joy with people, to make people smile? Charlie does. Charlie likes to do that through hugs. So we are gonna go sneak attack and share some joy with people, okay? So everybody get up, and we're gonna tiptoe and sneak up on some people to share some joy.
Let's go. Let's go. Tiptoe. Tell me if you see somebody that looks like they want a hug. Sneak attack! Hugs! Hugs! Oh, look at that smile. He just smiled so big. Shh. That's tiptoe.
That was a lot, Charlie. Whew. I have a question. Could Charlie share joy with hugs without any help? Could Charlie have shared hugs without me? No, Charlie's a puppet, right? So Pastor Scott just read this story about Paul and Barnabas. Hold on, that was a lot of running. That probably says more about me than Charlie. Well, I just realized, this is Charlie. Say hi, Charlie. This is Charlie too. Paul and Barnabas healed people. Could they have done that without God? No. But when they did it, the people thought they were gods, right? They were like, oh my goodness, we've never seen anything like this. You must be gods. But they were doing what God was doing through them. The same way that we can share joy and love and bless others is because God is in us, not because we do it by ourselves, but because God is with us, right? So whatever we do, when we do it for fun, when we do it to bring a smile to others, when we do it to share joy, that's God working in us, right? Say yes. So let's pray. Let's pray. Let's fold hands. Pray. Dear God, oh, sorry, repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for the joy that you give us as you use us to share it with others. In Jesus' name, we pray and play and share joy. Amen. Thanks. Go share some joy. You can give sneak hugs on your way back. Maybe your parents or somebody else. Go give sneak hugs. Here, give me a hand. I'm trying to help you up. There we go. Oh, oh, oh.
You can walk.
I'm just going to use that voice for the rest of the sermon.
Our text today opens.
You need a lozenge or something, don't you? It hurts after a while. Our text today opens with this scene, the scene that I will show you in just a second. Actual picture. Okay, maybe not. Our text today opens with this scene. A group of prophets and teachers in a church in Antioch. Now, who is this group? And what is it that this group does? Is this a Bible study group? Well, wait, maybe not a Bible study group, but a Pentateuch study group. Remember, there's no New Testament yet in our story for today. But we have this group gathered together in this place, and they must have been meeting there for a while. It is to where Saul/Paul and Barnabas have been sent. And they are all working in the church there in Antioch. And it is here that the early church is being formed already. Mission activities are being coordinated. Back in Acts chapter 11, we hear this about this church and the addition of Paul and Barnabas. It says, so it was for an entire year that they associated with the church and taught a great many people. And it was in Antioch that the disciples were first called Christians. And just remember what Christian means. Christ follower or a follower of Christ is a Christian. It is one of two things we might take with us this morning from this text. When you are in a cabinet meeting or maybe shoveling the walk outside here at OSLC after a snowstorm, when you are working on a quilt or serving a worship service as an usher or communion steward, while you serve on church council, and when you agree to help chaperone a youth event, know that you are connected. You, Christian, follower of Christ, you are connected to the very first followers, the one that are the framers of the church, the very first followers that were called Christians. Just like those first followers working together to bring God's work into the world with our hands, you need to know that your gift of service to the church and in this community through the church is important, of great value, and very much needed. We are the body of Christ, and in Christ, we are one body. The second thing that we might take away from our text for today is equally important. It is a commandment from Exodus chapter 20, verse 3, which is? Yep. You guys are just like the first service. Nobody knew there either. It's the Big Ten. It's the very first one. You shall have no other gods before me, right? It's actually the very first commandment. But we need to notice something that gets us to this important point today. As Paul and Barnabas begin their ministry in Lystra with their very first healing in this place, they are beginning to have a reputation as gods. It says, when the crowd saw that what Paul had done, they shouted in Lysonian language, "The gods have come down to us in human form." Barnabas they called Zeus, and Paul they called Hermes because he was chief speaker. Now, look, let's be honest here. If you were at work and you did something miraculous, even if by accident, wouldn't you take credit for it? You know, the president of the company comes and says, "We sold $1 million worth of product today, and you were the only one working today. It must have been something you did." Most people would be like, "We sold $1 million worth of product today, and you think I'm responsible for those sales? Well, okay." Doesn't everyone want to be the hero of a story? And the flip side of that is, doesn't everyone love to hear about a hero? Don't you love a story where someone has helped someone else? And don't we want to reward that person for being the hero? And as a society, we do. It is no wonder that after Paul said to this man who was crippled from birth, "Stand upright on your feet," and the man sprang up and began to walk, that everyone started worshiping Paul and Barnabas as gods who had come to do great things for them. People love a hero. Michael Jordan, Billie Jean King, Wayne Gretzky, Vince Lombardi. That's in there for our cheeseheads. Sully, Mother Teresa, even George Washington. I won't even start with movie personalities. And we speak about them with awe and honor. And in our story, we read about how the people who had witnessed this healing brought sacrifice to Paul and to Barnabas. And before you think, well, we don't do that today, do you own any sports t-shirts or hats, souvenir of some sort? Have you bought a book by your hero, bought a car or refrigerator because your hero told you in an advertisement to go out and buy that thing? Have you bought tickets for a game? Have you bought Taylor Swift tickets? What do you think a sacrifice is? We love a hero, and we love to honor our heroes with our sacrifice, with our offering. This is the crowd in our text today that have seen the wonders of what Paul and Barnabas has done. But our text is trying to teach us something today. What is it that Paul and Barnabas say to these people? They say, friends, why are you doing this? We are mortals, just like you, and we bring you good news that you should turn from these worthless things to the living God who made the heaven and the earth and the sea and all that is in them. Paul and Barnabas are such good missionaries because they know and are willing to remind everyone why they are in their town and who it is that has given them authority to do the things that they do. Paul and Barnabas go on to say, in past generations, God allowed all nations to follow their own ways, yet he has not left himself without a witness in doing good, giving you rains from heaven and fruitful seasons and filling you with food and your hearts with joy. They have been learning to do what Jesus has always done. Like Jesus, they point to God. If the crowd had been watching closely to Paul and Barnabas from the beginning, they would have noticed what Paul and Barnabas had noticed about the one that they healed. The text reveals, and Paul looking at him intently and seeing that he had faith to be healed. The actor in this healing is God. And even the faith that the person has who is being healed, that faith is a gift from God. Paul and Barnabas wants everyone with ears to listen, that they are not the ones doing anything other than what God has made possible. There should be no hero worship. But because people are people, and it takes a long time for them to learn and to understand, the text ends with this. Even with these words, they scarcely restrain the crowds from offering sacrifice to them. So even after Paul and Barnabas tell them, basically, don't thank us, thank God. Even after that, the people are still offering them sacrifice. Now, I don't want you to think that as Paul and Barnabas, or really as any of the disciples, went from town to town, they did a few healings, talked about the good news, and everyone became Christians. In many, maybe in most of the situations they were in, they would be persecuted and stoned by those who didn't want to hear what they had to say. So again, when you are talking to someone about coming to church with you, or you are trying to do something good for others, and as we encounter difficulties, remember those that have gone before you and the difficulties that they had to endure to continue to bring the message of good news. You are, as a follower of Christ, as a Christian, you are in good company. In just a few minutes, we're going to share communion. And in that sharing, we might all remember that in and through this sacrament, we are connected to all Christians. Communing today, all Christians who have ever shared the bread and wine in the past, as well as all of those who will share this sacred meal in the future. We are the body of Christ, and in Christ, we are one body. And so we pray. Good and gracious God, help us be one body in Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Gathered in community, we join with the whole church to bring our prayers before God. We'll end each petition with the words, "Merciful God, invite you to respond, receive our prayer." Later on in the prayers, we have a petition where we'll lift up the first names of members of the church and family and friends of members. Those are printed in the bulletin you have. We'll read those aloud by first name. You're invited to join along. Sustained by God's abundant mercy, we pray for the church, for the world, and for all of creation. Gracious God, we pray for the church. Bless partnerships with other Christians and interreligious dialogue. Guide the daily work of denominational and congregational leaders. Strengthen our combined witness for the sake of the gospel. Let your Holy Spirit blow through the Church of Christ on earth today and swing wide the doors of our buildings as you send us to go and be the church in the world. Merciful God, we pray for all of creation as we're reminded this spring with the signs of new life that you are the creator of all that is good. You've made all the birds that fly, the fish that swim, the animals that walk. You've made each one of us as your own masterpiece. Fill us with awe and reverence for the diversity of creation as we celebrate all that you have made. Merciful God, we pray for all the nations of the world. Topple the dividing walls that separate us from our neighbors. Form us into a beloved community where diversity of gender, race, language, sexuality, ability, and ethnic origin is celebrated and affirmed. Bring peace where there is war. Merciful God, we pray for all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit. Be present with all who are lonely and give courage to all who are afraid. Comfort those who live with chronic illness or other sickness. Bring healing to those who pray and cry out for healing. We especially pray for members of our Saviors, Johanna, Sharon, Andrea, Betty, Gert, Fred and Lois, Paula, Ron and Carol, Kent, Dave, Jerry, Don, Naomi, Jody, Marie, Jim, Art, Wendy, and Wayne. We pray for families and friends of our Saviors, Mary, Phyllis, Jamie, Jill, Lars, Emily, Anne, Maynard and Yvonne, Elijah, Frank, Max, Dan, and Bonnie. God, hear the names of the prayers and the silence of our hearts, those family, friends, and even strangers that we lift up before you in this time of prayer. May your living waters and grace pour out upon all who are in need. Merciful God, we pray for this congregation. We pray for those who are preparing for baptism, for those who are learning each and every day, as we each and every day, each of us learn to follow in your ways. Nurture us in faith and pour your love into our hearts. Inspire our community through testimony and shared story of your grace in our lives. Merciful God, we give thanks for all the lives of all your saints, the hope in your sustained lives of faith and service. Encourage us with the hope shared in you. Merciful God, we lift our prayers to you, O God, trusting in your steadfast love and your promise to renew your whole creation through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are able. The peace of the Lord be with you all. I invite you to share the peace of Christ with one another. We pray. God, you provide all that we need. Give us generous hearts that we might offer ourselves, our efforts, and our resources to your good work in the world. Accept now these gifts for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus gathered with the disciples in that upper room around a meal. He took bread, gave thanks to God for the gift that had been provided, broke it, and gave it to them, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And then again, after supper, he took the cup, gave God thanks for the gift, and then gave it for them to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." We join together and pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Those of you who are worshiping online, we invite you to gather the elements you have of bread and wine or juice, whether by yourself or with family or friends, to receive this holy sacrament. As you hear the words, "Take and eat, this is the body of Christ broken for you. Take and drink, this is the blood of Christ shed for you." If you ever need prayer, please don't hesitate to reach out to Pastor Scott or myself that we might hold you in prayer. Those of you who are gathered here, you'll be seated in just a moment. Wait for ushers to dismiss you forward. You'll come with your hands open to receive a gift. You'll receive the wafer, the bread, the body of Christ. Go ahead and eat that. After you take a few steps, you'll come to the tray. You'll take for yourself either the darker color wine or the lighter color grape juice, the blood of Christ. As you drink, you'll then move a few steps. Today is a fifth Sunday. Four times a year, there's a fifth Sunday of the month. When that happens, we have a little time of healing prayer. We have volunteers that'll be there with oil to make the sign of the cross on your forehead as they say a simple line of blessing and healing prayer. If you would like to receive that, just pause and let them do that. Otherwise, you are welcome to pass by. You'll dispose of your cups in the baskets as you make your way back to your seats. It is Christ who invites all of us to come to this holy meal, where we receive not just bread and wine, but through body and blood, we receive the grace, mercy, and forgiveness that is Christ's gift for all of us. If you've ever been told or made to feel by the church, by yourself, or by anyone else, that you are not welcome, know that it is Christ who welcomes you to come and receive this gift. Come and taste and see. You may be seated.
In the call of grace.
You know the Holy Spirit's here when the tray ends perfectly. You have just enough. That means the Holy Spirit is definitely here, right? Let's pray. God of the abundant table, you have refreshed our hearts in this meal with bread for the journey. Give us your grace on the road that we might serve our neighbors with joy. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And receive the blessing. God, who gives life to all things and frees them from despair, bless you with truth and peace. And may the Holy Trinity, one God, guide you always in faith, hope, and love. Amen. In case you don't know, the Holy Spirit is with us all the time and not just when the tray ends perfectly. I wanted to be clear on that. A few announcements before we sing our last song together and worship again. Wonderful that we can be gathered together. If this is your first time here or it's been a while, we'd love to connect and just say hello and talk about being in community together here at Our Saviors. We're glad you're here. Your announcements, they're online too. If you're worshiping with us online, you can find these on our website, oslcrockford.com. A few things in here, but just going to highlight a couple. May 21st, a big day for us. Pastor Dan Ruth from LPGM, Lutheran Partners in Global Ministry, will be our guest preacher that day. Our Saviors has a rich history with Lutheran Partners in Global Ministry that you'll hear about as we move into May. So he'll share some of that, and then he'll do an adult ed forum between services. So I encourage you all to come early for two reasons. One is to hear what he has to share. LPGM does transformational journey trips to Guatemala, India, and Tanzania. He's going to share some of that and see if the Spirit's moving for us to maybe plan a trip together in the future. And so we'd love for you to come and learn about that and their ministry in general. Also, May 21st is our Volunteer Appreciation Sunday. We want to say thanks for all that you do, not just for the ministry of Our Saviors, but the ministry you do as you go and serve in the community in various ways. And so that day we'll have a special guest with us. We have a new coffee company with us. The Vintage Goose will be here with their Airstream trailer serving specialty drinks and treats. So you want to get here before service because they are not here after this service. So come early that day to get your special treats. Also, May 21st, we have a Growing Families of Faith event. This is our group designed for families with kids, infant through fifth grade. Certainly older siblings, grandparents, others are always welcome. But we're going to head out to Lockwood Park that afternoon for a picnic and games together. And so let us know if you're coming and we'll have a fun time out there. I know bocce ball is on the lineup for the day. So other games as well. So we're going to have fun doing that. How many of you are golfers? They're not here. They're out on the golf course, aren't they? If you're a golfer, I'd love for you to join me and others at Our Saviors, Rockford Lutheran Ministries, and Katie's Cup, our Lutheran ministry downtown. Shared golf scramble coming up May 24th. I know we're into our second group of four that we've put together and would love to see us have three or four different groups from Our Saviors. So if you're interested, let me know. We'll put you on the list and join me and others May 24th for a golf outing. Our mission of the month this month, as the month comes to an end, is our own Playtown Preschool. It's a great ministry that allows us to not just teach some of our neighborhood kids their ABCs and 1-2-3s, but get to share the love of Jesus with them. And it's thanks to your support that we're able to do that ministry. So if you feel moved and are able to give above and beyond your regular offering, would love for you to support Playtown. Either you can put a check with the memo line or do that online to support that mission of the month. Check out all the rest. Certainly go online to get all the latest news if there's things you're looking for. With that, I invite you to stand as we sing together.
The rock for all ages, Jesus.
Today, Rock Valley Master Chorale will be here for their spring concert, directed by our own John Walquist. Many are Saviors members in that choir. So right where you're at, 3 o'clock concert today with a free will offering for KFAC, the ministry here in Rockford. Go in peace with Christ beside you.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. Have a great week.